Ever since astronomers discovered the existence of planets outside our solar system, the possibility of alien life has been one of the biggest mysteries of our time. Einstein's theory of relativity states that the universe is expanding faster than the speed of light, making it impossible to explore in its entirety. But this begs the question, are humans the only intelligent species that occupy this massive space? If not, where is everyone? New reports state that the James Webb Space Telescope may have finally found an answer by detecting signs of life on Proxima B. Let's take a closer look. 6 years ago, scientists made one of the most exciting exoplanet discoveries so far, a rocky planet similar in size to Earth, orbiting the nearest star to the Sun, Proxima Centauri. While the detection seems solid, more confirmation is always good, and the ESPRESSO spectrograph on the Very Large Telescope in Chile provided that extra and more detailed confirmation. The news was announced by the University of Geneva on May 28, 2020, and the planet was named Proxima Centauri b. In the past several years, astronomers have found a large and growing number of Earth-sized exoplanets orbiting distant stars. Some are in the habitable zones of their stars, where temperatures might allow liquid water to exist on their surfaces. That is exciting in itself, but Proxima Centauri b is of particular interest since it's orbiting the closest star to our Sun, only 4.2 light-years away. Its confirmation underscores current findings that such worlds are common in our galaxy. Proxima Centauri b is very similar in size to Earth, with a mass of 1.17 Earth masses. It orbits its star in only 11.2 days, in contrast to our Earth's year-long orbit around our Sun. That means Proxima Centauri b is a lot closer to its star than Earth is to the Sun. But because the star is a red dwarf, much smaller and cooler than our Sun, its orbit is indeed within the habitable zone of Proxima Centauri. Interestingly, Proxima Centauri b receives about the same amount of solar energy from its star that Earth does from our Sun. So theoretically, Proxima Centauri b could have water on its surface. It could be habitable, but, of course, we don't know yet all the details about the habitability of exoplanets. We do know that many factors affect a planet's habitability, such as temperature, the composition of the planet, and atmosphere, water, and radiation from its Sun. Red dwarfs like Proxima Centauri are known to emit flares, and these flares make habitability for red dwarf exoplanets even more complex and interesting. Astronomers first found Proxima Centauri b in 2016 using an older spectrograph called HARPS. The newer spectrograph, ESPRESSO, said to be the most accurate in the world, was able to conduct radial velocity measurements on Proxima Centauri that are the most precise to date. A total of 63 spectroscopic observations of Proxima Centauri were acquired by ESPRESSO in 2019. The confirmation of Proxima Centauri b is exciting, but there may be more surprises in store. There is also possible evidence of another and smaller planet in the newest data. Secondary detection was also made, although it isn't certain whether it's a planet. If it is, it is even smaller than Proxima Centauri b. If it is a planet, it would be more akin to Mars or Mercury in size and mass, estimated at a minimum Earth mass of 0.29 plus or minus 0.08, and it orbits the star in only 5.15 days. It wouldn't be too surprising, though, since low-mass stars like red dwarfs tend to have multiple planets in their systems. More observations will be required to either confirm or refute this possible second planet. Last January, another research team announced their finding of another possible planet orbiting Proxima Centauri called Proxima Centauri c. This one is also still just a candidate at this point, but if real, it is about 6 times as massive as Earth. This would make it a super-Earth, planets that are significantly larger and more massive than Earth, but smaller and less massive than Neptune. It is estimated to orbit the star every 5.2 years. If both of the new candidates were to be confirmed, that would mean Proxima Centauri would have at least 3 planets orbiting it. Proxima Centauri is the nearest star to our Sun, although it is a part of a 3-star system, including the 2 stars of Alpha Centauri. They may be the closest stars, but the planets don't transit in front of the Proxima Centauri as seen from Earth, as most exoplanets are found, so astronomers have had to use the radial velocity method to find them, where the planet's gravity causes a slight wobble in the star's motion. While little is known so far about what Proxima Centauri b is actually like, just the fact that it exists around the nearest star to our solar system supports previous research showing that Earth-sized and super-Earth-sized planets are common in our galaxy. That is exciting and bodes well for the search for life elsewhere. One potential problem, though, is that red dwarf stars are very energetic and emit dangerous radiation that could strip the atmospheres off of planets that are too close. Whether this is the case for Proxima Centauri b is not yet known. If it does still have a substantial atmosphere, it would be an ideal target for other telescopes to look for possible biomarkers and chemical signatures of life. The confirmation of Proxima Centauri b, now the nearest confirmed exoplanet, is exciting. Its potential habitability and proximity to our solar system give us something to think about. It's another big step towards finding an inhabited world beyond Earth, and the newly launched James Webb Space Telescope may have done just that. The JWST is a state-of-the-art space telescope that is a culmination of 30 years of research and development costing $10 billion. Calling it one of the grandest scientific endeavors of the 21st century wouldn't be a stretch, as it represents the future of space observation and one of the things we will rely on the most to increase our understanding of the universe in the coming decades. The telescope has the capability to see just about anything in the sky, but its main objective will be to observe light coming from the very first stars to shine in the universe. This will make it possible for us to see the moment when darkness ended and the first stars came into existence for the first time. Because of the complexity of the equipment, the James Webb Telescope has had to sit through various delays in development, but now that it is operational, it'll help us answer some of humanity's greatest mysteries. Having the ability to accurately trace sources of light millions of miles away is one of the biggest reasons why the telescope may be the first piece of equipment in history to finally discover traces of intelligent life in the universe. And as Proxima b seems to be one of the leading candidates to host an alien civilization, the telescope may be our only hope for finding answers. There is a good chance that the planet has water on its surface, which is essential for the survival of life as we know it. It is tidally locked like our moon, which means that Proxima b would always present the same face to the Proxima Centauri. The side facing its sun will have a desert hot light climate, while the other side is deep frozen at the same time, but there will be a twilight zone band around its mid-region where the star is always just above or just below of the horizon. In this region, the temperatures won't be as hot or cold, but then a tidally locked planet has its advantage. For example, if humans were to live there, it means solar energy farms would always generate electricity and will be distributed to other parts of the planet. Colonists could just select a location with any average temperature they wanted and could hide from the periodic solar flare by keeping Proxima Centauri just over the horizon and out of harm's way. Even if there is no native life in Proxima b, it may become an advantage because many arbitrarily branched points on the evolution of life could have resulted in life evolving on other planets very differently from what we have on Earth. This type of alien life will most likely be toxic to humans, so for a colony site, a sterile planet is preferable to a biologically hostile one. Water is said to be present in Proxima b, however. Scientists don't know for sure the amount of water Proxima b had initially, but their calculations have shown that it could have lost one ocean's worth of water to the earlier radiation in the first 100 to 200 million years after formation. The first clue of the possibility of intelligent life on Proxima b was discovered back in 2019 when a strange signal was picked up coming from the direction of the planet by the Parkes Radio Telescope in Australia. Although the reports are still a bit unclear, the signal reportedly showed up during five different 30-minute periods over several days while the telescope was directly pointed towards the planet. Based on the information available so far, the signal was concentrated into an extremely narrow range of frequencies, which points toward it being artificial and distinctly unlike any known natural radio sources. One of the biggest lingering questions at stand is that if the signal does turn out to be of extraterrestrial origin, should humanity send them a reply or not? However, our technological limitations mean it would take just over a decade for the message to reach the planet. The next step in this discovery is to identify all possible sources of terrestrial interference in the data collected from the strange signal. Since such a massive discovery will change the course of human history and our understanding of the cosmos forever, the scientists involved are rightly taking every step necessary to correctly identify the origins of this signal. One of the ways this can be achieved is by observing the planet through the James Webb Telescope. When viewing the Earth from space, the most obvious sign that a civilization calls the planet home is the glow of lights from the night side of our planet. The massive cities which are visible from above emit light that is shed into the cosmos. The biggest problem we have had so far is the lack of technology to observe similar lights on planets outside our solar system, but this will all change thanks to the James Webb Telescope. While the observatory is hard at work collecting data from the exoplanet, it will take many years before scientists can definitively confirm if the planet hosts alien life. Whether there is life anywhere else in the universe is one of the most important questions in science. The universe might be teeming with life, or maybe we are alone. marooned in a lonely world in the vastness of space? The definitive answer, either way, will likely require profound psychological and philosophical adjustments for humankind. If you found this video interesting, please consider taking a look at this one, which talks about a habitable super-Earth found just 37 light-years away. Do you think Proxima B is home to an intelligent civilization? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.